A big hello, hola, salut to all of you, my listeners, colleagues, and friends. My name is Rudolph Broomes. I'm an analyst at BNP Paribas in Portugal and a BNP Paribas CIB Portugal brand advocate, also known in short as a connector. I'll be your host of the Switch Talks podcast. And throughout these episodes, me alongside some very exciting guests, we're going to share a few more of the projects within the Switch strategic program. Are you ready to start sharing new ideas? Let's do this. For our debut episode, and keep calm, this is not a pilot. For our debut, we are going to talk about the BNP Paribas Portugal employee value promise and its communication through the employer branding campaign. So today we have two very special guests with us to enlighten us on the topic. First up, we have Hervé Reynaud. He's the head of human resources here in Portugal. And with a name like that, you can see it was a bit of a serendipitous moment that he became the head of HR here. And he is also the project co-sponsor of the employer branding campaign. Next, we have Sofia Teixeira Mendes. She's an internal communications and events officer, and she was a project contributor for this employer branding campaign. Okay, to start, for Hervé, for those who may not be familiar with the topic, first of all, what is an employee value promise?
Hello, everybody, and thank you, Rudolph. So what is an employee value proposition or promise? You will hear both because sometimes it's called an EVP, and value proposition or promise, but it's still an EVP. So it's an EVP is a set of values that the employer, the bank, is offering to its employee in order to federate them and create a community of people who works in the same direction and with the same goals and for the benefits of all of us. Just what I'd like to do a brief reminder of on how this EVP was created last year in 2019 as part of one of the Switch initiatives. So this set of value is really the result of a numerous surveys workshop held last year with a high participation of many of our employees. And through these surveys and workshop, we wanted to ensure that there was a good match between our employees' expectation and what the bank as an institution wants to offer. Guess what? We had a very good match. So that was reassuring. And in addition, and very importantly, the group was carrying out the same type of exercise at the same time. And our local EVP is very close, if not really almost identical, of the one that was proposed by the group, which again is reassuring. So we have at group level, at local level, and based on employees' expectation, a set of values which are really the one that are federating us. So they should be known by all of us, and that's why we are launching this main campaign, with one main objective is engage and perform. Or perform and engage. Because indeed, I think we really need to have engaged employees around a set of values who are striving to make our company performing at its top.
Okay, so can you go into a little bit about what our local EVP is?
Yes, so our EVP was organized around three pillars and 12 attributes. So I will go around, I will describe the three pillars, and I think I'm sure you will discover the 12 attributes, four for each pillars. That was the source of inspiration in the way we are performing our jobs and act on our daily basis. So the first pillar is solid and responsible international leader. I think the recent sanitary crisis has proven once again that we are effectively a very solid bank, which can go through all the turbulences and the difficulty of our economy, of our society at large, and in the world of today. Why I think that's very important, constantly remain very close to our clients and serve the real economy. So this first pillar, solid and responsible international leader, because we are operating in 80 countries around the world. The second pillar is committed to people development. So people, as you know, are our main assets, and we will only progress if our people find all the necessary means to develop themselves within the company and remain engaged. So very important, the second pillar is committed to people development. And finally, the third one is in a positive and open environment. So we are working in a complex and changing environment, and we want to remain constantly in synchronization, in sync with the main challenge of our today's world. We are not an isolated and self-sufficient ecosystem. So I think it's very important. So we are connected with the world, with the outside world. It's crucial that we do all what we do has a meaning for the society at large, and what we contribute to the, that we contribute to the main challenge of our society today, be it environmental discrimination, or even more recently, sanitary challenges. We will not resolve all the problems of the world. That, I think, is something that we need to forget. We are not there to solve all the problems of the world, but it's our duty to bring our contribution to the solutions that the world needs today.
Okay, so I think to sum it up, in those three pillars, we're a responsible leader, we're committed to people, and we all want to work in somewhere that's positive and open. So then, Hervé, what are your expectations towards the communication of our EVP to the staff?
Yes, so we all know that today the job market has shifted. We have now candidates that choose whom they wish to join and where they want to develop. And this is why the campaign is named Not Your Choice, and Sofia will describe it later on. But so it's important that our EVP is well known, both internally and externally, in order that to ensure that our current workforce, as well as the future workforce that will join us in the near future, adhere to this set of value, remain engaged, and for the benefit of all, is performing. So in other words, in the more classical way to express it, is attract, retain, and engage, that everyone knows. But I think it's really making sure that everyone adheres to values which allows us to perform at our best.
Okay, so then to what extent do you consider that, considering the period that we currently live in, how important is it to communicate about the EVP?
So on one hand, yes, our local EVP, the local promise or proposition, how you call it, that should reassure staff. I think, yes, the first one, the first pillar, we are a solid and international bank. I think we'll really remind our staff that we are going through a crisis, as we have done already in the past, and there will be new crises. But, and then since the creation of BNP Paribas, it's not the first one that we are going through. But as I said earlier, we are connected to the real economy. So some of our clients will suffer. We will be impacted by this crisis in our different business. But also, I think it's important to remind that we have a very diversified business model, CIB, but also the retail bank, the IFS, Pole, that will enable us to go through these uncertain times. So reminding this first pillar to our staff today is reassuring that they are in a solid and a sustainable bank. On the other hand, I think it's important that we keep a very close and transparent communication, even if today we do not have the physical contact. As we know, we are all facing this interaction on the basis of, as of today, Microsoft Teams, Skype, but it's very important that we keep connected, we keep close to each other, and that I think is really even more important today than ever.
Yes, I definitely agree with that. Staying in touch is a lot harder since we're all having to do it remotely. Now, thinking about the challenge then, Sofia, how do you plan to meet these objectives? How is your team going to implement the employer branding campaign here in Portugal?
Okay, first of all, our campaign is totally aligned with the wider campaign already launched by the group called Your Choice. You may have seen it on LinkedIn because they were very, very present at that time. And what I mean by this is that we will meet all the objectives and also the design guidelines defined. But besides that, and to make it our own and let's say made in Portugal, we will adapt it to our positioning, context and culture. I think it's easy to understand that we really want to translate our reality and meet our current and future employees' expectations. And for that, we will count with a group of colleagues of 20 people, our EB faces within BNP Paribas in Portugal, that best represent the bank's purpose and promise. However, you will need to be a bit patient until you meet them. It will not take too long, I promise, but they are not ready yet. In the meantime, what I can tell you is that all the initiatives related to this campaign will be stamped by the label your choice, and some of them are almost out of the oven. So you just have to pay attention.
Some of the evidence of the local EVP that are going to be stamped on your choice under this campaign?
Yes, sure. So I think I will describe four forthcoming events, which are really, as Sofia said, really starting soon. So first one is the Mobility Days. So Mobility Days, and the search for you, is for from the 20th of September to the 2nd of October. So it is tomorrow, which fits with our people development pillar. And one of these one more of these attributes is diverse career opportunities or cross expertise journey. I think the best way to develop in the company is to have a diversified career within the organization and explore all what it has to offer. We are lucky that effectively in Portugal, we have many businesses represented, CIB with all its businesses and operation front to back, but not only group functions, wealth management, and other entities within the group, such as personal finance, Cardiff. So all this wide range of activities is a unique opportunity for all our employees to discover where they can evolve and how and when they can develop within the company with different type of job. So I know in the current context, we are going, as I said, we are going through difficult time. We all know that we are also hit by hiring freeze because the management is very cautious on the near future, but it's not a reason not to believe that we still have some opportunity. So maybe the mobility will not happen tomorrow or the day after tomorrow, but it will come, and that there will be always opportunities in a developing entity such as Portugal, where all the time there will be new opportunities. So really, the Mobility Week is a unique opportunity for all of the employees to participate to all the workshop and all what is proposed, to discover whatever is proposed within the group, be it in all the entity of the group, but in Lisbon and in Porto. So that's the first event, which is really close to us. The second one is the Diversity Week from the October the 12th to October the 16th, so very soon as well. So again, a perfect fit with our positive and open environment or its attribute, including atmosphere. So it will be the fourth edition of the Diversity Week with a specific focus this year on gender equality and disability, but not only. Our network, Pride, Well Abroad, all our network are actively participating and animate many of the events. So raising awareness, and I think everyone is convinced that raising awareness and strive for a better integration of all our people with any kind of differences will only make us better, richer, and align with our society. So the third event that we also have been launched, this one has been launched last week. It's a series of events which is called Let's Prepare for the Future. It's a EMEA level. It's at EMEA level, and it has been launched with the communication last week by the head of CABHR, Laure Morsi. So it's a set of webinars, conference, video that has been revised and a revised training offer as well, which has been organized in order to help all our employees, managers, and team members to navigate in this challenging environment, be it with a remote working or a different way of working. So again, it's a perfect fit with our EVP, it's develop and empower our people and its attribute training academy. So I really encourage you to follow on the connect all the announcements around this campaign, Let's Prepare for the Future. And finally, I think it's an event which will, another project which will come a little bit later on the 1st of January next year, but it's very close. It's a Benefit Plus campaign, the Benefit Plus platform, which is a platform of benefits in which every employee will be able to select the benefit they want according to their specific need at a given time of their life, be it in terms of life insurance, health coverage, child expenses, or technology equipment. As we know that someone at 25 years old, 30 years old, 40, or even 50 years old doesn't have the same needs. So the benefits schemes that will be and the benefit portfolio that will be proposed by the company through this platform will be fit to your specific needs at the given time of your life, depending on your age or family situation. So this will be launched on the 1st of January next year, but the campaign, the communication campaign, will start as early as October. So it's really very close as well.
Yeah, I've really enjoyed the Mobility Days and the Diversity Week. I've participated in them personally in the last 3 years. So I'm really looking forward to those in October. It's usually a pretty fun and also very interesting, interactive events lined up for us. And also looking forward to the launch of the Benefit Plus platform. When I was 25, I was invincible. I didn't need health insurance. Well, I definitely have changed my mind on the necessity of health insurance. Okay, so Sofia, what and when can we expect to see more from this campaign?
Well, in terms of when, I think it's easy to understand that it will be very, very soon. Because in fact, we are lucky enough to work to a company that since always develops great initiatives, as Hervé already mentioned a few, which will be all communicated through digital display, internally and externally, social media. Yeah, pay attention to our spokespeople LinkedIn pages, corporate TV and out-of-home advertisements, such as posters, billboards, etc. Our intention is really to be everywhere. And besides all of these channels, we have just launched an exclusive page about our local EVP, where everyone will be able to find everything that is being done. So if I had to suggest you a new favorite web page, I would say this one definitely. Do not miss it. Okay, Rudolph?
Okay. Okay. I will definitely pick upon it, bookmark it, do whatever.
Exactly.
So I can actually be there ready for the launch.
We count on you, Rudolph. Yes.
For sure. So we have a few questions which were submitted by our listeners out there in advance. So I'd like to ask you both a couple of questions that they submitted. So first, Hervé, I'd like to ask you, in which ways can employer branding help our current employees?
Values is essential. So first of all, you need to know these values. And I think what the company has to offer is these values. So for us, it's really important that people are working around a set and known set of ensemble of values. So clearly, helping a current employee, yes, it will help to engage them around this set of values, but it's important that they know them. But I think it's really important that everyone in the company knows what we are all striving for.
Okay. I think that actually goes in well with the second question that was submitted. Will the employer branding campaign be able to reduce the employee turnover?
It's a difficult question because I don't have a crystal ball. And you know, turnover is always something very delicate. We don't know how it goes. It will not solve all our problems. Let's face it. Let's be realistic. It will not solve all of our problems. But really, I strongly believe that engagement is a source of motivation. If you're not engaged, you cannot really give your best to perform. So adhering to the common value, being engaged, is certainly a way to motivate our people. Now, with that, reduce our turnover. Only the future will know, and maybe we'll have this type of conversation in 1 year time, and we'll see. But it's a combination of factors, the turnover. But this one, adhering to a set of values, being motivated and engaged, and working in the same direction is certainly one way to motivate our people and to stay, to remain engaged and to retain them. So it should reduce the turnover.
Yeah, I definitely agree with you. I believe it makes logical sense. more motivated employees or happier employees, and they would want to definitely stick around. Okay, so Sofia then, our final two questions for you. And the first submitted by our listeners, what skill do you think is the most important to be a connector? And I promise I didn't ask this one.
Okay. I bet you did not. So that's an odd question because having to choose only one is hard. But if I have to choose just one, I would say that they have to be true influencers. They have to have the capability to influence others, encouraging them to take on other initiatives, other events, to participate, to get involved within the bank. So that's really important. And also to be masters in communication. I think that's very important. They have to be open and to communicate very clearly to our employees.
Okay. And convincing as well. They need to have the power of conviction because they need to spread out this this set of values to their colleagues. So it's important they can convince. They are themselves convinced of this set of values, and they can convince them to convince others.
True. Okay, Sofia, so take us behind the scenes a bit. What was the most funny episode about choosing the connectors?
Okay, so all the process was very fun. We received a lot of applications, and that was really a good surprise for ourselves. But I would say that maybe not the funniest thing, but the greatest thing that we saw, it was to having so many employees recommending other employees. You know, that was really strong to notice. We have this strong sense of belonging, and we are free to encourage others to participate. And that was really, really good to notice. That happened a lot, really a lot.
Okay, cool. Thank you so much for your answer so far. We have one final quick challenge for both of you. I'd like to play quick game of this or that, so that our listeners get to know you all a little better.
Okay.
So, Hervé,
yes.
Don't be scared. There's no right or wrong answers, or maybe they are. So let's start with you, Hervé. The Alps or the Algarve?
The Algarve.
Ah, okay. You're a local already. Yes. So then, a croissant or pastel de Belém?
I'm sorry, croissant.
Ah, okay.
I'm missing the Parisian French croissant. Yes.
it's hard to argue with that. Yeah. And then, you know, it's dinner time. You have some friends over. Do you reach for a Vino de Porto or a red Bordeaux?
A difficult one, this one. Can I say both or?
This or that.
To start with. A white Porto, and then during the lunch, a red Bordeaux. I'm sorry, I can't help you, but no. If I have to choose, it would be the red Bordeaux. I'm sorry.
Well, it makes sense. One is for before, one is for after. So that's, exactly. I think we shall allow that answer. Okay, Sofia.
Okay.
First question, summer or winter?
Oh, that's easy. Summer. I'm already said that it's coming the winter. So yeah, summer for sure.
Nothing like going, you know, on the beach, working your tan, fresh fish.
Exactly.
Typical good things, summer.
Only good things. Yeah.
Yes. Good. Skype messages or Skype calls?
Okay, I prefer Skype calls. I think it's easier to catch up. It's easier to reach the other. So if someone is ignoring you, just have to do a call. You know, like it's really, really simpler. So, yeah.
Okay, Skype calls. You're a communications master, so you should definitely know. It's easier. There's too much that can be lost in translation.
Of course, that as well.
Message to someone. And then finally, books or movies?
We cannot choose both, right? Okay. It depends in our in my mood. I really like both, so books and movies. Maybe I'm right now I'm more of a books person than a movies person, so I would say books.
Okay, I'm understanding the current context of COVID.
maybe
you know, our movie persons, or at least going to the theater, that is.
Exactly.
Okay. So Hervé, Sofia, thank you so much for your time, and to all our listeners, thank you for tuning in.
Our pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.